This is the first Zilka Symposium. This is a wonderful symposium that actually brought together the world leaders in Alzheimer's disease that work in different areas. They work in areas of genetics, they work in areas of vascular contributions, they work in areas of inflammation, on brain mapping, and the role of different cell types in brain and how they contribute to Alzheimer's disease.
My mother had Alzheimer's for many years before she died, and my eldest brother Abdallah also had it. And my eldest sister, Helen, had dementia. It's not important for the Zilka neurogenetics to necessarily be the one to find a way to arrest and reverse this horrible disease. It's important for someone in the world, wherever it is, to do that.
Today, you know, we can say that a woman older than 60, you know, really has a dramatically reduced risk of developing breast cancer, and that the risk for Alzheimer's, unfortunately, over 65 for a woman is twice as high. So the good news is that we have made some great strides in breast cancer, and it's all due to our investment and commitment to research. We can do the same thing for Alzheimer's disease, and it's time to do that now, because we are facing today an epidemic that will continue to be with us for this entire century if we don't do something to turn this around.
It's true that there's a big challenge in the budget for Alzheimer's disease and actually for all of the federal budget. In light of that, actually, it is wonderful that the president was able to add $100 million per year to the NIH budget specifically for Alzheimer's disease, and it really highlights the importance of that particular area, and we're all grateful for that and recognizing that the effort and commitment that represents.
We have to go broader and deeper. And what's so exciting at this conference, which is bringing in a bunch of what I call Navy SEALs to the job, is that we're now looking beyond just the neuron, which is the final one that's injured, to all the supporting cells, the microglia that are cleaning up the garbage, like the beta amyloid toxins, which create inflammation, and also the role of the vasculature. So it's a whole concert in the brain, and we have to understand the whole thing.
Let's not forget that most of the Alzheimer's cases are not genetically transmitted. 98% are not. So where we are, that's why I think vascular factors are really huge, because if we take care of it, you know, we can minimize the risk and we can develop new treatments to actually specifically target brain vascular function. And I think we can do that.
I think one of the most important things is the breadth of the science. You know, looking at factors that can be measured from the genetics level to the cellular level, all the way up to the systems level, are really important in trying to understand the interplay between those observations. And so in our world, we take brain maps and we relate the data that comes from all of these observations into a comprehensive whole. And we can actually do that pictorially. So you can look at these images and understand very complex data in a visual way.
I think it's one of my best accomplishments, really, to get all these people who are usually in different places in the world at this time to come and spend time with us and share their input and their opinions. So we heard the best of genetics, a lot of unpublished data. All speakers were talking about unpublished data. There was really an open exchange, and as Mr. Zilka pointed out, it doesn't really matter who is going to discover cure of disease. We just have to get it done. And so that's what I'm committed here. We have a pretty remarkable group of people here at the ZNI. We have to be very proud of this institute.